I'm Baz, co-director of the movie Game of Death, here at FrightFest London.
What does it mean for you to bring the film to FrightFest?
It's amazing. I've heard lots of good things about FrightFest. I love London, one of my top cities in the world. This is my third time here, and we're just here in and out for 48 hours, and I'm just super anxious to see how the public of London will react to Game of Death.
Hi, my name is Sebastian Landry. I'm the co-director of Game of Death.
Sebastian, it's fantastic to have you here at FrightFest. What does it mean for you to bring the film to this festival?
It's really unbelievable. It started as basically just high hopes of doing like festivals or just like for the movie to be seen, and to be here at FrightFest, it's completely amazing. It's my first time in London, my first day in London, and I'm here in like the square. It's like, it's amazing. I feel like a superstar, but it's like I don't want to be a superstar, just in a good way. It feels very good to be here. So basically the story, it's about a bunch of teenagers who find a board game called A Game of Death, and they realize that they have to kill 24 people or they're gonna be, their heads gonna explode each other. The inspiration came from many parts, but it was mostly like a mix of video games. We really love video games, and also Jumanji, so, and Battle Royale, so a mix of many things that we loved, and we put it together.
We had so many references that I think we often describe it as being like Jumanji meets Battle Royale or Natural Born Killer and this kind of thing, but it's more for the press to understand the movie. While we were writing it and creating that movie, so many references came in that it's more like our life as a reference, everything we saw, the internet culture, all the music videos we did. With the two of us, maybe 70 music videos. So all those experiments came in play with the final aesthetic. But there are some little Easter egg in the movie, like the room that Samantha, the little girl in the hospital, is the same room as The Shining. So yeah, there's some little Easter egg, but overall, like, you know, some people like say Tom has a funny game look. Yeah, it is. So it's just like little things, but it's not really, I couldn't say it's an influence. It's more Easter eggs.
Sam Hall is the guy who plays Tom. He kind of plays a psychopath, and he's a genius. He's a really, really, really good actor. And Victoria Diamond, her twin sisters, that they play as like the bad team, if we want. They're both magnificent actors, and I'm really glad they accepted to play in the movie.
We just have the chance to work with the best in the world for us in Montreal, with Rémi Couture, who's the guy who did all the prosthetic, and the Blood Brothers did all the on-set effects. They were super creative, super talented, ended up coming up with like crazy ideas to make the head swirl. At some point, Rémi had a straw and was hiding behind the actor and just to make the heads well. So it was super important for us to have real effect, less CGI possible. We just feel like a movie age way better when it's on set effect, practical effect, and it looks just way better, so real.
What I love the most about horror, it's like it's trying a new thing every time, because you have to find a new way to scare people, to impress people. So it's always good creative people that brings together an energetic ways to, okay, let's redo the genre every time. So you have to be constantly creative about things. So that's what I love the most. No barriers. We have to break the barriers.
I'm kind of noob in the horror genre. I did a short called that was named La Chienne, Cage in English, with Seb, and now we did Game of Death. So for us, we kind of discovered this. There's no freedom like in this genre. I've never seen any other type of cinema where you can go that crazy, explore that much, and to have an audience that is super tight and that is waits for the new stuff and that craves the new stuff, and they're really open to enjoy it, they're really open to hate it, but they have opinions. And I feel like in this niche the relation with the creators and the audience is super tight and super interesting to evolve. It makes you evolve as a creator, makes the audience evolve. There's a lot of, I would say it's the niche that there's the more dialogues between creators and audience.